ground, the home of the Mariners since 1999, T-Mobile Park here in Seattle. We've got the American League Championship Series on the show. It's the Tampa Bay Rays taking on the Seattle Mariners. With my partner Chris Singleton, I'm John Schaub. It's been quite a series so far, and the excitement's only ramping up as we get ready for Game 5.
Yeah, and even though neither team's going to be going home after today, Game 5 always has the feel of an elimination game when the series is tied up at 2-2. And maybe it's just as important as one, because being up 3-2 as opposed to down 3-2 makes a huge difference going forward.
Yeah, you don't want to be the team with their backs up against the wall in Game 6. This is a big swing game. First pitch coming your way next. Just about set to go now. And today's starting pitcher, Chris Flexen.
Well, this guy featuring that straight four-seam fastball, but off of it throws the cutter, and really he's most effective when he's using that cutter off the four-seam fastball just to miss the barrel of the bat. Not always going to see the swings and misses, but if you can somehow get weaker contact, you have a chance to collect some outs. Now, it's going to look the same until the very last second, so hitters are going to have to make a decision and hope that sometimes they're able to guess right.
There's a swing and a drive. That ball's carrying. Hauls it in on the warning track.
Batting second, the shortstop, Wander Franco.
Here's Wander Franco. That one to first. France takes it to the bag. Two up, two down. Two outs, base is empty. Austin Meadows now. No score, just getting started. Top of the first. Next offering is fouled back. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And that is that.
I think the key is arm action on the changeup. When you can sell it like a fastball, you drop the velocity, you get the swing and miss, and you walk off the field.
We go to the bottom of the first, and pitching in this game, Corey Kluber.
Boogie pitched into the seventh, earned the W in his last start. He really needed that one. Well, this team needs another one today. We'll see if he can carry that performance into this game.
Bottom of the first, here's Adam Frazier. For a strike. Now it's 3-2.
Really good cutter that he's able to front door and back door. That pitch is devastating.
Right through there, got him. And there's one away. And up next for Seattle, Ty France. And the pitch. That one off the mark, 2-1. That misses off the outside edge. The wide to kick the pitch. In the air to left center. Makes the grab on the run. And there's two down.
Batting third, the designated hitter, Jesse Winker.
Here's Jesse Winker. One of the best in the game against right-handed pitching. The lefties, however, that's another story. That that one down the line. It's in and out of his glove. But they get the out at first, and that'll do it for the inning. Mariners are down in order. We played an inning, no score. Top of the second. Now it's Randy Arozarena. Singy, is this more common today? Guys really only succeeding against pitchers throwing from a specific side?
I think it's because you just don't get a very long trial period anymore. I mean, with the analytics and the numbers, teams are looking for instant success with the lineups that they construct. So if you don't figure it out quickly against certain types of pitchers, you're just not going to get those opportunities.
The throw to first. Leadoff man retired here in the second.
No, he didn't recognize changeup earlier enough. Got out in front a little bit, rolled over on it, and beat it into the ground.
And now the hitter, G-Man Choi. Swings and misses. It's 2-2. Towards first, can't field it cleanly. Tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. Two up, two down in the top of the second.
That is it. The third baseman, the two, Yandy Diaz
now. Pitch. That one the other way. He can't get there. That should be extra bases. Makes the turn and heads for second. The throw in, but he's in there easily.
Well, they call that an advantage count for a reason. You're so much more likely to get something you can handle. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly. Runner in scoring position now, and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame. Well, they're looking to get on the board first here after that clutch two-out double made this inning interesting.
Manuel Margot up to the plate. Down the right field line. That's a base hit. And that's going to roll to the wall. Run scores easily, and it's 1-0. Pulls into second. That's an RBI double.
Always feels good when you come through and get your team on the board first.
He really shot that one down the right field line and somehow found a way to keep it from slicing foul. One thing that was great about the approach is head was down all the way through the pitch, and that's how you do it.
Now the catcher up to hit, Mike Zunino. Big time power and a pitch. Line drive caught. One in the inning, and it comes from a rather unlikely power source. It's now 1-0. We head to the bottom of the second. Now batting Mitch Haniger. Swing and a miss. And it's 1-2. The wind of the pitch. And a ball evens the count.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
And a swing and a miss. And quickly one away in the second.
Man, I really like the ability to bounce back right there after not getting a call. He probably should have gotten. He didn't let it affect his focus, and he came back with another good pitch to get him swinging.
Hey, Eugenio Suarez up to hit now. Next pitch is outside.
through there for a strike.
James Kingsley working the plate. Kingsley's pretty well respected around the league.
Yeah, when you talk to players, I think consistently he is one of the guys you hear compliments about. Players appreciate the job he does back there.
Yeah, and that's kind of all you can ask for, really, just a fair chance to go out and have success.
Margot drops steps, heads back on it, snags it on the run. Two down.
Batting six. Not shortstop. J.P.
And now J.P. Crawford. Liner, and that should be extra bases. Around first, digging for two. And the double puts the tying run in scoring position with two away.
Nice double right there. Loud contact coming off the bat. Didn't get enough air under to drive it out of here, but you'll take that swing and that result every time.
Man in scoring position with two away. This is Kyle Lewis. Man at second.
Three ball, two strikes.
And he walked him. Goes to third, in there. And now they've got runners at the corners with two outs. Here's Jared Kelnick.
Well, there's a reason why he's at the bottom of the order, struggling as of late. But a knock here would be a huge lift for him and for his team.
Tying run in scoring position. The Rays leading on the solo homer. On the ground at first. Choi steps on the bag, and that is that. Mariners leave a couple. They're down 1-0. On to the third inning. Here's Kevin Kiermaier. Three, two. Swing and a pop up. Foul territory for the catcher. Makes the grab, and there's one down.
The batter number eight, second baseman, Brandon Lau.
And now it's Brandon Lau. He provides a surprising amount of pop from the second base position.
Listen, that's not something to take lightly. Getting that kind of production from the guys up the middle, it's not a strength of most lineups.
Next pitch is outside. And what does that do for a team when you get power from unexpected spots like that?
When you're in the dugout and you see a guy come up big like that that you don't necessarily expect it, it just energizes that entire team.
And here it comes. Oh, now this one's high and deep, way back there, on its way, gone. Brandon Lau bops one out of here. He's up to three home runs in the series. It's 2-0.
What I love about this swing is he stayed tall, allowed his hands to go directly to the baseball, letting that bat head get down through the ball to create backspin and hit it out of the ballpark. Really nice job.
Base is empty, one away. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Wander Franco. 0-for-1, he grounded out to first his last time. Next offering misses, and that's ball two. That hits the dirt, and now 3-1. And a foul ball. This to center field. Lewis settles underneath it, snags it for the second out.
Now batting, designated hitter, Austin Meadows.
Now it's Austin Meadows. He was a strikeout victim his first time. Here's a 1-2. On the ground to the left, Suarez handles the chance, tosses across to first. That ends the frame. But add on one more as the solo shot stretches their lead even further. And it's 2-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. So here's Murphy now. Next offering is fouled back. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. Leadoff man retired here in the third. Here's the Seattle leadoff man, Adam Frazier. That one ripped. That's a hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock. And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
One gone, runner at first. And now for Seattle, Ty Frank. This one swung on and hit well. Way back there. And it's gone. Ty France goes deep, and they add a pair. It's 2-2.
A good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
So one out, nobody on. Jesse Winker up next for the Mariners. Next pitch misses way outside.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
Pitch on the ground right side. Lau sends it to first, and Winker is set down.
Now batting right fielder Mitch Haniger.
Mitch Haniger up next for the Mariners. Tied up here in the early going. And miss, struck him out. That's the third out, inning over. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run homer. 2-2 game. Start of the fourth, here's the left fielder, Randy Arozarena. And a 1-1. And that gets the inside corner for a strike. Righty delivers. And a foul ball. He stays alive.
He's mixing his pitches really well. Late on that.
that fastball after seeing the changeup. See if he can elevate one. I think if he does, he'll get the swing and miss.
Next one just misses. 2-2.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Swing and a foul, pushed off to the right, and that will get out of play. The wind of the pitch. Bounce to third. A dive. Nice stop. The throw, and that's a great play for the out. My goodness, Singing. That was a great diving stop, and maybe even a better throw.
Yeah, this out is all about athleticism. I mean, this guy did a great job knocking it down on the dive, but he doesn't get the out without the cannon of a throw. That was just impressive all around.
Now up for Tampa Bay, G-Man Choi. That's to third. Suarez gloves it, fires across the diamond. Two quick outs here in the top of the fourth.
Now batting, third baseman, Yandy Diaz.
Yandy Diaz, next to hit for the Rays. Doubled his first time up. And he deals. In there. And so now 1-2.
Man, I mean, nice job just presenting it to be better than it actually was.
The 1-2 stays alive. One and two here. Swing and a bouncer. Fires over to first. That's the third out. Nothing doing for Tampa. Score remains 2-2. Back at T-Mobile Park, ready to go. Bottom four. Stepping in, Eugenio Suarez. And a pitch. Up the middle. Lau over to pick it up. Whips it to first. And one gone in the fourth as they get the leadoff man.
Now batting, shortstop, J.P. Crawford.
And here is J.P. Crawford. Doubled in his first A.B. Pretty good job on the mound in this one, Singy. It feels like we've seen a lot of off-balance swings.
Yep, just one free pass, and obviously he's not a big strikeout guy, but he gets soft contact and he gets outs.
One down, base is empty. That one hit to right. Margot puts it away, two down.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
Two outs, base is empty. Kyle Lewis, the next to hit. Two outs. Got him. And that is that. And 1-2-3 go to Mariners. Score remains deadlocked at 2-2. Welcome back. Ready now for the fifth inning. Here's Manuel Margot. Lifted in the air right center field. And that'll fall for a base hit. So a man on base to start the inning. So Margot is aboard.
Wasting no time. He's 2-for-2 now on the night. And just a triple and home run away from the cycle.
Seriously? We're starting with this already. Go ahead, run on base. And stepping in for the Rays, Mike Zunino. 0-for-1 so far. Next offering is fouled back.
With two strikes. May see some movement over there at first base, try to stay out of a double play here.
Next pitch is in the dirt. The count now 2-2. Kicks and deals. Ground ball right side. It's through for a hit. Lead runner to second. So two on and nobody out. A perfect example right there. That plate discipline, it pays off.
The deeper he gets into a count, the more comfortable he becomes, and he usually wins the battle.
Here's Kiermaier now. Here's a 1-1. And a sack bunt here. Off balance feed, there's one. And he'll eat it and be happy with the out. So the Rays batting order turns over. Stepping in, the long ball threat, Brandon Lau. Next offering is in for a strike.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
Next offering is fouled back. Right-hander kicks, deals. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Runners are at the corners, one away. And it's even up. Riding to the plate. Oh, now this one's blasted deep to left. Way back there, on its way and out of here. Brandon Lau goes the other way with it. And now they're out in front. It's 5-2.
That's the exact definition of hitting the ball where it's pitched, taking that outside fastball and driving it the opposite way out of the ballpark. You want to bottle that type of approach.
One down. Wander Franco getting ready to hit. And the right-hander deals. Little chopper rolls foul. High fly ball out of the left center field. Kelnick makes the catch. Two away. Now it's Austin Meadows. Ground ball, left side, and foul ball. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. Three-run bomb for Tampa Bay. It's now 5-2. Bottom of the inning, and stepping in for the Mariners, Jared Kelnick. The M's in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. I need a good at bat out of him right here.
And the next pitch is way outside.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
And a 2-2. Drilled in the air, right field, way back there, and that is out of here. A solo shot, and they cut into the deficit. It's 5-3.
Oh, that one got in the jet stream on a line drive. We saw the numbers on the backs of the jerseys of the outfielders, which is usually bad news, and all of a sudden, they're back in this ballgame.
Now it's Tom Murphy. Here comes a pitch. Off the mark there. 2-1. The pitch. Swing and a ball lifted in the air, left field, pretty well struck. That one's back. Out of here. Tom Murphy sends it out, and they slice into the lead. It's 5-4. That's their third home run of the game.
They're having a lot of fun at the plate in this one. They've got the long ball working for them on autopilot. Back-to-back jacks, and this club is fired up right now, Boog. I mean, this is the kind of thing where you really start to notice hitters in a lineup feeding off each other, and the collective confidence just continues to grow.
Now it's the second baseman, Adam Frazier. Bouncer to Choi. He steps on the bag, one away. That ground ball may have him back on track after the homer. And here's the first baseman, Ty France. Out towards left center. Pulls up and it drops for a hit. One down, runner at first. Now it's the DH, Jesse Winker.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play.
The pitch. And that misses off the outside edge. At the belt and fires. And that's ball four. Mitch Haniger now at the plate. And there's no doubt that they'll feed off the energy from this crowd, right?
I mean, yeah, I'd say the intensity level has gone up a few notches for sure.
The 1-1. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball. The 1-2. A Rosarena on the move to his right. Puts it away for the out.
Yeah, that was a wasted RBI opportunity, but competitor like him, he is looking forward to making up for it in his next at bat.
Hey, Eugenio Suarez up to the plate now.
Well, look out here. He's going to come up ready to swing in this situation.
Up the middle and it gets through. Flying around third is France. The tag and he's safe.
Gets it done to drive in the run and tie it back up. Pitch was on the outside, didn't go the other way with it, but still a nice job of using the big part of the field to find a hole. No way he hits it that well if he hooks around the baseball there.
So first and second with two outs. J.P. Crawford will hit next. The next pitch misses. Full count now.
Yeah, I'm surprised we didn't see a visit from the pitching coach here. Just to remind him, focus on the hitter. Don't worry about anything else.
two outs. A couple of base runners at first and second. Fly ball down the line. A Rosarena racing to his right. Brings it in with a nice running grab. And that will end the inning. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. All even at five apiece. Back here at the ballpark, top six. Now the left fielder, Randy Arozarena. Next pitch misses, and that's ball three. It's a leadoff walk, and that's the go-ahead run.
Oh, that's a really dangerous base runner to put on first, especially in a tie game. Now there might be some consequences coming from that mistake.
New pitcher for the Mariners, Justice Sheffield.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
No outs, runner at first. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, G-Man Choi. Trying to move him over here. On to France, out on the sack bunt.
The third baseman, number two, Yandy Junior.
Now up for Tampa Bay, Yandy Diaz. Game tied, series tied. This could be a turning point in this series if he could deliver.
Indeed. If he comes through with a hit here, it's going to change the entire approach that they can take against their opponent.
Swing and a slow roller. Over to first. Got the out.
Good fade and sinking action of that changeup. Got that hitter to roll over.
Manuel Margot, next to hit for the Rays. Man on second, two down. The other way, makes the grab, and that's the inning. 7-8-9 due up in the home half of the inning. We're all tied up, 5-5. Jeffrey Springs takes over on the mound.
Now pitching for the Rays, number 59, Jeffrey Springs.
Bottom of the sixth inning. Now at the plate, Kyle Lewis. The lefty ready, and a 1-1. Swings here and blasts one left field. Back there. Pulls it in on the warning track.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
And up next for Seattle, Jared Kelner. 3-1 now. Popped up to the left into foul ground. And he dropped it. So that's a foul ball, and he gets another chance at the play. The pitch. The punch out there, and there's two down. Tom Murphy digs in now. And a pitch. And that's outside. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Ryan Thompson getting loose out there. Rayleigh, the lefty, warming up as well. And now a full count.
I got 3-2.
And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Mariners go down quietly there. And this remains a 5-5 ball game. And welcome back. Top of inning number 7. And now the catcher for the Rays, Mike Zunino.
He's a big, strong guy. Can untie this game with one swing.
And the pitch. And there's a fly ball deep right field. In one hops off the wall. Should be extra bases. Throw cut off to second. Not going to get him. He's in there.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there.
Just a great approach. Looked like that was exactly what he wanted to do with that pitch. And right off the bat, he knew he was taking that wide turn at first to head for second.
Now a good opportunity to potentially jump ahead in this game here in the later innings.
And stepping in for the Rays, Kevin Kiermaier. Runner leads away at second. Next offering is outside. Go ahead run in scoring position. Nobody out. Two and two. That one missed.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Well, they didn't give him anything to hit, and now with runners on first and second, they've set up a double play opportunity. So not a terrible result.
Left-hand batter waits. Bounce back to the mound. Got him on the off-balance throw. And that is a big first out.
Deceptive slider right there. Stayed in the tunnel a long time. Got that hitter out front. Rolled over it. Put it on the ground.
So two in scoring position with one out. Now batting Wander Franco.
Listen, there's absolutely no reason to pitch to this guy right here. You nibble, you see if he'll expand his zone, but don't give him anything to hit. If you walk him, not a big deal. You have a double play opportunity set up.
1-1 now. In the air out to center, Lewis. On the move, heading back. Back some more. Brings it in. Runner tags for home. That's a sacrifice fly as he comes across, and it's 6-5.
No, this is a big at bat right here. Nice sack fly to give his team the lead in these late innings.
Here is Austin Meadows. In the air, center field. A little bloop single. The run comes in to score from second, and they take a two-run lead.
Well done. Drives in the run. These days, most outfielders play pretty deep, and I'm not sure if that was a factor there or not, but off the bat, you're thinking it's going to be a pop-out, and it just kind of nestled into that spot where no one was able to get to it.
Runner at first with two away. Here's a speed threat, Randy Arozarena. Way out front for strike two. Sheffield to first. Meadows dives back in safely. And a pitch. And that one in the air center field. And puts the squeeze on that. And the inning is over. Seventh inning stretch time. It's the Rays 7 and the Mariners 5. Brooks Raley gets handed the rock out of the pen, trying to protect this lead. Back in Seattle, bottom of the seventh, here's the second baseman, Adam Frazier. The 1-1. Foul ball there. He swings and hits a fly ball, center field. Frazier retired. Then there's one down.
The first baseman, number 23.
And now for Seattle, Ty France. He's already homered here in this one. And now the lefty stays alive. Kicks and fires. This one chopped up the middle. Now the throw to first on the run. Two up, two down.
Now back, the designated hitter, Jesse Winker.
Two outs, base is empty. Jesse Winker up next for the Mariners. The pitch. That one misses. Ball two.
You get to this part of the order. Yeah, there's some pop there, but more likely there's some base hits. So very important to be patient. Let the pitcher walk you, if he will.
Line drive. Makes the catch, inning over. Nobody left for Seattle, and they're down 7-5. We're at the top of the eighth, and now the first baseman, G-Man Choi. Next pitch is outside. And here it comes. Bounce to the right side. Frazier on to first in time. Leadoff man is out here in the eighth.
Up next for Tampa Bay, the third baseman, Yandy
Diaz, getting ready to hit. Why to kick the pitch? Line drive, and that's a base hit out into center field.
That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride and load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Manuel Margot next to hit for the Rays. Kicks and deals. Cap dances out of the way of that one. Lined into right. Two down.
Not fooled at all right there. He was clearly all over it, but sometimes you hit it too hard and right at someone. You're looking for one of those bloop hits to get a knock sometimes.
Anthony Misevich gets the ball now, and he'll do his best to keep this close.
Number 18, Anthony
Here's Mike Zunino. And the 3-1. And ball four, two aboard.
Not what he wanted to do right there, Boog. That keeps this inning alive, puts a runner into scoring position, and a chance for this offense to add on to their lead.
Kevin Kiermaier next to hit for the Rays. First and second, two down. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Chases that one out of the zone. That's out number three. So the Rays strand a pair. They're still up 7-5. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, JT Shagwa. Back at T-Mobile Park, and here is Mitch Haniger. And he deals. Pitch misses there, 2-1. Righty delivers just off the outside edge. And the right-hander's 3-1. And a foul ball. In the air to left, down the line. A Rosarena under it. Puts it away for the out.
Now batting, third baseman, Eugenio.
So up next, Eugenio Suarez. And a pitch. Late with the swing there. Right-hander kicks, deals. That's off the mark, and that's ball three. Out to short. High throw to first, and he can't reach it.
Shortstops have to make some pretty difficult throws across the field sometimes. Might have tried to put a little too much behind that one, but clearly he got under the throw. Didn't stay on top. Not a good release point, and it just took off on him.
J.P. Crawford, the next to hit. Here's a 1-1. Slapped foul. Runner at second here, one gone. Smash to the left side. That's a base hit. Stop sign goes up at third. Runners at the corners with one out.
Just a huge at bat right there. Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team at bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep. Now a huge at bat in this game coming up.
Making a move at first. Entering is the pinch runner, Billy Hamilton. Two on, one out. Kyle Lewis up next for the Mariners. Swing and a miss. Slider right there.
In the infield at the corners, don't be surprised to see them come home first and prevent that run from scoring.
Two now. Hit slowly on the ground. Goes to second. Safe there. No play. That's an infield single. Here's the left fielder, Jared Kelnick. This is what stat nerds like myself might call a high leverage situation.
Yeah, but not sure what the numbers say, but clearly an at bat that could change the course of this game dramatically. Lots of anxious fans in the ballpark right now. You can feel it.
Back and forth we go. A seesaw battle in the late stages of this one.
These home fans, they are making a lot of noise, putting pressure on that pitcher out there.
And a swing and a miss. And there's two away. On the mound now, Peter Fairbanks. He has a great slider with tons of movement.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the ball. Number 29, Peter Fairbanks.
And now the catcher comes up to him, Tom Murphy. And the righty deals. Swing and a high fly ball. That one out towards left center field. Way back there. Out of here. A three-run shot, and that's how they take the lead. It's 9-7. Singy, he's been red hot.
Yeah, another big swing of the bat for him. Man, he is really seeing the ball well in this one. They thought he could blow a high fastball by him, but he was ready for it. Look at how quickly he jumped on that pitch.
Adam Frazier up next for the Mariners. Two down, nobody on. And that one lifted in the air center field. He's got it. And that is out number three. But the big blow of the inning comes right here. A three-run homer. Last chance for the Rays coming up. Welcome back. And here comes the closer, Paul Sewald. Dylan Moore, he's the new shortstop as he comes in as a defensive replacement here. Welcome back. All set to start the ninth in this one. Here's the Rays leadoff hitter, Brandon Lau. Gets him to chase after that one.
Guy out there sees a power hitter take that kind of swing. He's got to be thinking, is this guy trying to set me up? Now let's see if he can make an adjustment.
To the right side, Frazier handles. One up, one down.
Good slider inside right there. Batter fighting to get there, just rolled over it, got the ground ball.
Wander Franco now at the plate. The 1-1. Smoked on the ground a second. Gathers and throws to first. Franco gone on the play.
Fastball groove right down the middle. Usually a lot of damage done with that pitch. A hard grounder, but he wanted to get that ball in the air. Maybe drive it into the gap.
At the plate now for the Rays is the DH, Austin Meadows. Here's a 1-1. And that one wrapped foul. Next pitch off the plate. And the count's even at 2. And a swing and a miss. And that is the ball game.
Well, these guys were able to take the lead in the bottom of the eighth and just cruise to this win, getting those final three outs at the top of the ninth. Excellent job of securing your home field and keeping the fans in the ballgame all the way to the end. Nice W all the way around.
And 9-7 is the final here in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew here at MLB The Show, thanks for stopping by. I'm John Ciambi. Talk to you soon.